mathematicians, it's Justin again, and welcome back to Mia's Measure and Mix Bakery. In our last lesson, we measured the ingredients needed to make treats for the bake sale using units of volume. Fluid ounces, cups, pints, quarts, and gallons. Today, we've got a different kind of project. All those treats are about to come out of the oven, and we need a place to display them at the bake sale. Building something like a display shelf requires a different set of measuring tools. Units of volume aren't going to be very helpful here. These pieces of wood need to be cut to the right size. So what do you think we'll be measuring? Yeah, length. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to identify different units of measurement and the tools needed for measuring length. You'll also practice reading measurements and converting from one measurement unit to another. Have your guided notes ready, and let's get building. Let's check out the tools we have so we can pick the right one for the job. Recognize any of these? This is a ruler that measures from 0 to 12 inches. Remember, 12 inches is the same as 1 foot, or about the length of a laptop. This is a yardstick. What do you notice about the units of measurement on it? It's 36 inches, which is the same as 1, 2, 3 feet. That's about the length of a baseball bat. And this is a tape measure. This one has a 25 on the side. Do you think that means the tape measure is 25 inches or 25 feet? Pause to record your thinking in your guided notes. "25 inches is right here on the yardstick. Since we already have a measuring tool that can tell us 25 inches, this tape measure is going to help us with lengths greater than a yardstick. That means the tape measure can reach up to 25 feet. That's like all the way across the room. There's another unit of measurement that we just don't have a tool for here, and that's to measure length in miles. Miles are huge. We need over 5,000 rulers just to measure 1 mile. We definitely won't need miles to measure anything in the bakery today. So, between the ruler, yardstick, and measuring tape, which would you pick to measure the length of this pencil? It looks to be about 6 or 7 inches long, so the ruler would probably work well. How about the fridge over there? It's definitely longer than a pencil, so the yardstick or the measuring tape would work better. Now that we know a bit more about our measuring tools, let's help Mia with the display shelf. All right, this piece of wood needs to be cut to the correct size for the shelf legs. We need to figure out where 29 1/2 inches is so Mia knows where to cut. Between the ruler or the yardstick, which measuring tool would work best here? The yardstick will work well since it has measurements greater than 12 inches. The zero on the yardstick is lined up with one end of this piece of wood. Here's the 29-inch mark and the 30-inch mark. And then there are lots of little marks in between. Notice the mark right in the middle? There are also two that stand out here and here. If this was a number line that went from 0 to 1, how would we label those marks? With 4 parts, it would be 0/4, 1/4, 2/4, which is also 1/2, 3/4, and 4/4. We're looking for 29 1/2 inches, which means Mia will need to cut right here. The other side needs to be 32 1/4 inches long. Pause here to find that measurement on the yardstick so Mia knows where to cut. Finding the 32-inch mark first can help. These longer marks show fourths, so 32 and 1/4 is right here. Up next are the shelves. Mia's already cut them, but she's not sure which is which. They're pretty long, so our tape measure can help here. This tape measure shows measurements in inches. Pause here to record the length of each shelf in your guided notes. This shelf's length is exactly halfway between the 67 and 68 inch marks, which is 67 1/2 inches, while the other shelf is 64 3/4 inches long. While Mia finishes putting the display shelf together, let's check out what else we need to do to prepare for the bake sale. We need to buy a table cover for our checkout table. The table is 5 feet long, but all the table covers are listed in inches. How will we know which one to buy? We need to convert or change our units of measurement. Converting a unit of measurement from one to another doesn't change its value. It's just like regrouping. So how can we figure out how many inches are equal to 5 feet? Just like when we were working with volume, we can use patterns or multiplication. 12 inches is the same as 1 foot. That means 24 inches is the same as 2 feet. Pause here to figure out how many inches are equal to 5 feet. Multiplying the number of inches in 1 foot by 5 feet equals 60 inches. Completing the growing pattern also proves it's 60 inches. We also need to pick up some paper and string for to-go orders. I need 120 inches of string and the string is sold by the foot. We just converted 5 feet to 60 inches, and now we need to convert 120 inches to feet. Huh. Multiplying helped us figure out the number of inches in 5 feet. So how could we figure out the number of feet in 120 inches? I think we need to do the opposite. But what's the opposite of multiplication? Division! Dividing 120 inches by 12 equals 10 feet. Based on the pattern here, does 10 feet seem reasonable? 120 is twice as much as 60, and 10 is twice as much as 5, so yeah, we'll need 10 feet of string. Time for paper. 24 feet of paper should work. And just as I expected, the store sells paper by the yard. How many feet are in a yard again? Right, 3 feet equal 1 yard. So we're going from feet to yards. Should we multiply or divide? Multiplication works well going from a bigger unit to a smaller unit, and division works well when going from a smaller unit to a bigger unit. Since we're going from a smaller unit, feet, to a bigger unit, yards, division will work here. Pause now to convert 24 feet into yards. Since there are 3 feet in 1 yard, we can divide 24 feet by 3 to figure out how many yards that is. 24 divided by 3 equals 8, which means we need 8 yards of paper. Bake sale, here we come. So, what have we learned today, besides the fact that every inch counts when getting ready for a bake sale? Well, now you know that length is a measurement of how long something is from one end to the other. Length is measured in units like inches, feet, yards, and miles. You also know that multiplication and division can be used to convert measurements from one unit to another. Be sure to complete the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to practice working with length. This display shelf looks fantastic! We have one last step before heading to the bake sale, decorating and preparing the treats for our customers. Remember, mathematicians, in math, as in life, practice makes progress. I'll see you next time!